Colonel Sellin, you're reporting up on your site on the Gateway Pundit. You did this interview. You actually take it to a whole nother level. You say, hey, ladies and gentlemen, you got to back off here. This thing, they're so the PLA and the Chinese Communist Party is so infiltrated into our research apparatus, whether that's the University of Texas at Galveston or even at Fort Detrick. We got about a minute here. We're going to hold you over the break. Tell us what your theory of the case is, sir.
Well, here's the story in a nutshell. Inside Fort Detrick, there are two major institutes, research institutes, the United States Army Medical Research Institute of Infectious Disease, USAMRIID, where I work, and the Frederick Cancer Research Center, which is part of the National Institutes of Health. And before we go into a break, what I can say at this point is that the People's Liberation Army has always been interested in infiltrating USAMRIID, but it was difficult to do. So what they did, starting in the mid to late Clinton administration, they attacked the soft underbelly of Fort Detrick, which is the Frederick Cancer Research Institute, and CCP scientists started coming to the Cancer Institute, because before that, there was actually very little contact between USAMRIID and the Cancer Institute. They did cancer, we did Army biodefense. So,
I got to ask you a question. You came, you're one of the top guys, a revered guy at Fort Detrick. Fort Detrick is the elite of the elite of the bioweapon defense in the world. Explain to our audience, how does PLA-associated doctors, Chinese Communist Party doctors, even get on that base, regardless if they're working on one of Fauci's and Collins's NIH thing? How does that happen? You can allow Chinese Communist Party scientists near, anywhere near Fort Detrick. Tell me how that happened.
Well, it's because there's no national security accountability. And as I said, they couldn't immediately get into USAMRIID, so they started coming in the mid to late 90s to the Frederick Cancer Research Center, which is a walking distance from USAMRIID. And the CCP scientists, when they got there, they actually switched from cancer and started working on dangerous viruses, which they were collaborating with other Chinese scientists inside China. So this piqued the interest of the people inside USAMRIID, and you started seeing collaborations between USAMRIID and the CCP scientists at the Frederick Cancer Research Institute. And then sometimes some of those scientists would be working temporarily inside USAMRIID. And then finally, we have this Chinese CCP scientist, his name is Dr. Kevin Zhang, he uses Kevin, who came into the U.S. through the Frederick Cancer Research Institute, is now a permanent employee at USAMRIID. And in 2018, because they never sever relationships with their institutes in China, he went back and did a grand tour of lectures throughout China, including the Wuhan Institute of Virology. Now, the other interesting thing is he comes from the Southeast University, which is in Nanjing. And Nanjing is the headquarters of the PLA's Eastern Theater Command. And this is the command which isolated the bat coronaviruses, which Dr. Li Mengyan says is the backbone of COVID-19.
Doctor, and Colonel Sellin, because you're both, you saw Fauci in that interview actually have a Freudian slip and say communist before he caught himself. Do you think the pressure is starting to build around Fauci? He understands that people that have the facts are now starting to focus on his central role in all of this, sir?
Yeah, I think Anthony Fauci is toast. He was not just involved in funding the gain-of-function research, which I have found that continued even into last year, although it was done with dengue virus. He's also involved in funding all which have links not only to Chinese virus research programs, but through them connections to the People's Liberation Army. He also was involved early on in the effort by some U.S.-based scientists, Peter Daszak, for example, to actually suppress any discussion of the laboratory origin of COVID-19. This was done very early on before anyone could have possibly known its origin, the end of January, the beginning of February. And Dr. Anthony Fauci was involved in those discussions. In my opinion, he's gone along with this to suppress any discussion of the laboratory origin. And now he's getting caught up in it. He's, you know, the rat caught in the cage, as you said.